Hey everybody, and welcome back to part 9 of this tutorial series. So in this video we're going to be creating the time blueprint, and since we did the day and night cycle in the last video, I thought it'd be a good idea to sort of add the time and date. So let's go ahead and open up the third person character. So first let's find a bit of space, and then we want to right click and we want to add an event, so type event tick. And we should already have one, but if we click it, it'll take us to where the event tick is. So we already have the event tick working for the battery drain. If we drag this out and then type sequence, and we can add a sequence here. And then what we're going to do is just disconnect this by holding control left click, and then just plug this in. Then if I grab this and bring it up here, and there we go. So now I can drag this out and start working on the time. But before we do that, we need to create some variables. So go over here to variables, create a new one. So we could do seconds, minutes, and hours. But since the time is advancing so quick in the game, I think seconds would just be pointless. I'm going to do it anyway, but in the final example, I'm probably going to get rid of it. So let's go ahead and rename this. I'm going to call it time seconds. And then we can change this to an integer, which is a whole number, and then save this. Then we want to right click, duplicate it, and then just delete this and call it time minutes, duplicate it, time hours. So now we have these variables, we can move on. I'm going to take this pin here, just drag this out, and then I want to delay this, so type delay. So I need to set a value for this, let's say 1 second. We will need to come back to this and play around with the values because we need to match the world time, but for now 1 second will be fine. So for every second, we want the variable time second. So let's grab this. We want to get this. Let's go back. And we also want to set this as well. Set time seconds. Plug this in. So we have the time second variable. So by default, it will be 0, as we can see here. Let's drag this out and then hit plus. And we can select integer plus integer. So for every second, it's going to be plus 1. Plug this in. Then let's drag this out. Type branch. So we could drag this out and then do it that way, or you could grab another reference just to keep it tidy. It's entirely up to you. I don't mind having strings going around the place. So I'm going to drag this out. Now for this, if we type greater, you can see we have two options, but we want integer greater than integer. We're going to say if time seconds is greater than 59, so let's type 59, and then plug this in. Then as soon as the time second is greater than 59, we just want to set the seconds back to 0. Plug this in, back to 0. So there's your seconds done. Then after this set node, we also want to set the time min, so grab time minutes, bring this over. Set time minutes, plug this in, then grab a reference of it, get time minutes, and just as we did over here, we're going to add one, so integer plus 1, plug that in. And again, just as we did before, once it hits 59 minutes, or once it's greater than 59, we want to set the minutes back to 0, but then increase an hour. So it's fairly simple, it's not too complicated. It's just repeating this first process, but for the minutes and the hours. So let's go ahead and do that. So now we need to decide, is it a 12-hour clock or is it a 24-hour clock? I'm going to use the 12-hour clock. So by default, the time hours, we can see it's set to 0, which wouldn't work for a 12-hour clock. So what I'm going to do is just set this to 12 to be the default. Then from here, we need to just add another branch. And then the time hours, just drag this and then greater than, so then once it's greater than 12, so then we just need to duplicate this, control W, connect this up, and then we need the time to be 1. There we go. And if you want to do a 24-hour clock rather than a 12-hour clock, it's pretty simple. All you need to do is really just change this to be 23. So once it's greater than 23, then you want to change this to 0, which will be 12 o'clock. So now let's comment all of this. Let's compile that. There we go. So that's the time variables done. The next thing I want to do is display this time, whether it's on the HUD or the journal. So let's close this down. So it's up to you if you want to display it on the screen by default, or if you open up your journal, then we could just display it on the journal. So it's entirely up to you which way you want to do it. Either way, it's pretty much the same process. So you can go ahead and open up the HUD or the journal blueprint. I think I'll do it in the journal blueprint, so go ahead and open it up. So we've got a whole bunch of stuff here on the screen from the journal. There'll be a link up here. I'm going to go down here and just hide everything that I don't need to see. The way this works, we just need to create some text and then bind it. And it's pretty much the same as what we've done before by binding the battery counter. So I could go over here to the palette and then type text and then just add some text and then play around with it. But since we already have some text on the screen, which already has the same settings that we need, so what I'm going to do is just select this one, duplicate it, and then let's grab it, this one over here. Then if we go to the content and change this, for now I'm just going to hit zero. And then we also want to scale this up a bit. Then if we duplicate this, I need to grab this, bring it over. I'm going to go to the text and just change this. So this is going to be the hours. I duplicate it again. This one's going to be for the minutes. So I'm going to select this one, duplicate it. Select this one, duplicate it. And just move them back over here. So something like that. I mean, it's probably too big, but you get the idea. So now we have these in place. Let's select each one of them and then create a binding. We can refine this and make it look a lot prettier, but for now I just want to make it work. So select this one and then go to content, and then where it says text, we're just going to create a binding. So first, I'm going to go here where it says get text 0. I'm going to rename this. And this is going to be get time seconds. Now all we need to do is grab the time variable. So let's scroll down here, find where it says player character. And if you remember, this variable is essentially us casting to the third person character, which we did in a previous video. So we want to get the player character. Then drag this out, and we want to get time seconds, and then just plug that in. And there we go. That's all we need to do. Compile it, then go back to the designer, and then just do the same thing for the minutes and the hours. I'll create a binding, make sure you rename it. Grab the player character variable, drag this out, and then you want to get time mins, plug this in, and compile it. You guys get the idea now for the last one. So when it goes to 1, that'll look fine. 2, 3, 4, 5, it'll look fine. But when we go into double digits, like 10 o'clock, we can see it now overlaps the other text. Move this over a little bit. Like that. Now if we change this back to 1, you'll see the problem that we have. We have this big gap here. So let's change this back to 10 for now. Then if we scroll down, we'll find the justification. Let's change this to align to the right hand side. So it doesn't look like much has changed, but if we scroll up and then change this back to 1, so you can see the time is ticking away. Again, we can always make this look better. I think the font for this doesn't really work, so I'm going to go find some more font for this. Open this back up and then go back to the third person character. Then for your time variable here, we can change the duration. So if it's ticking too slowly, we can always reduce this. If we say 0.5, so the time should now speed up a lot quicker. Hopefully you're enjoying these videos, and hopefully you found this video helpful. If you did, be sure to give the video a like. As always, thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.
We'll be right back.